People often ask me,
Nick, how should I prepare for my trip to South Africa?
Not like this. How's it, everybody? It's great to be back on your screen again. Today, I want to chat to you about something close to home. One of the questions I get asked the most as a tour guide is, how safe will I be when I visit South Africa? And my answer is always the same. If you pay attention to what you are doing and what's going on around you, you'll be as safe as I am. And I live here. So if you're planning a trip to sunny SA, no matter if you're young, old, group traveling, solo traveling, or volunteering, here are my 12 tips on how to stay safe when visiting South Africa. As soon as you land at the airport in South Africa, get yourself a South African SIM card from one of the kiosks at the airport or at a cell phone shop near your accommodation. This will allow you to keep your mobile data on and you wouldn't have to rely on finding Wi-Fi spots for doing things like ordering an Uber or using Google Maps. And you'll also save some money by not having to use international roaming. As a tour guide, I prefer to use a Vodacom SIM card because I found that they have the most reliable network coverage in South Africa. Just be sure to tell them that you are a foreign traveler so they know what you need and how to help you. So now you're going to save the local emergency numbers to your phone, like the police, ambulance, your tour guide, accommodation, and your consulate or embassy. It's also a good idea to send a copy of these numbers to a close friend or relative back home. If an emergency situation happens, you won't want to waste time in searching for these numbers and you'll know exactly who to call. Ask your tour guide or accommodation if you're not sure where to find the right numbers. But to make things easier for you, I've linked an infographic in the description below for you to download, which has all the important numbers for the major cities in South Africa. Well, it's no secret that South Africa doesn't have the most reliable public transport in the world. Hey, but we do have other options. Before arriving in South Africa, you can pre-arrange a rental car or for your accommodation to send over a driver to meet you at the airport. Otherwise, you can take one of the meter taxis waiting outside or order an Uber. There is Wi-Fi at most airports, so ordering one is easy to do. I prefer to use an Uber because they're fast, reliable, and often work out cheaper than the other options. Also, the drivers give good tips on cool local places to visit. Just a side note, Uber is only available in the major cities here, and if you do order one at night, I recommend that you travel with a buddy or in a group. The best ATMs to use are the ones inside a shopping mall or at your accommodation, not the ones that are situated on the street. I usually look out for an ATM that has a visible security guard nearby. Remember, never accept ATM help from strangers. Rather go into the branch if you're unsure or ask your tour guide to go with you. It's better not to carry too much cash with you in South Africa. And if you do need to use cash, carry small denominations and do not store it all in the same place. Luckily, most places here accept card payments. I recommend that you only take cash for the souvenir and food markets if you're taking a taxi and if you visit the local bars or pubs. You'll also want to keep a few coins on hand to tip the parking and petrol attendants if you're renting a car. It's a good idea to keep your passports locked safely away at your accommodation and to keep a copy of it on your phone. This will prevent it from getting lost or stolen while you're out exploring. It will also make the check-in process a lot faster when you first arrive at your accommodation, and you won't have to dig deep down in your luggage to find it. If you're the kind of traveler who likes to walk and explore, check with your tour guide or accommodation for which areas and routes are safe for walking. Otherwise, join a local walking tour, you'll find plenty of them in the major cities and most of them are free. If you're walking around at night, walk with friends, stay in a group and stick to the well-lit busy areas. I can't see my As we know, South Africa is incredibly beautiful, and there are many places where you're going to want to stop and take a quick photo or a selfie. Although it might be easier to carry your camera around your neck or your phone in your hand, it's better not to flash your expensive gear while you're out in public. And of course, it goes without saying that if you're walking while staring at your phone, you're not paying attention to what's going on around you. Be travel wise. Some South Africans follow the philosophy of finders keepers. If you carry a handbag, a backpack, or travel pouch, be aware of it at all times while you're out in public. If you lose sight of it for even just a second, don't expect it to stick around. I always keep my backpack close to me while I'm out with my guests. I carry only what I need in it, and I leave the rest of my stuff locked safely away at my accommodation or in the trunk of my car. So if you're driving in your own car or rental car, I recommend that you keep the doors locked and keep your valuables out of sight or in the trunk. Smash and grabs can happen at our stop streets and traffic lights. Now let's go see how we can be safe on the hiking trails. If you go hiking, like up the famous Table Mountain, it's best to hike in a group. If you are a solo traveler and not sure how to find a group, check at your accommodation if there might be other guests who are keen to hike with you, or ask about scheduled hiking tours in the area. Remember to charge your phone and let someone know where you're going and which trail you're hiking, and have those emergency numbers saved to your phone just in case. It's always a good idea to take with a hat, enough water, and sunscreen. As you can see, South Africa has some of the most amazing beaches, but not all of them are safe for swimming. When going to the beach, make sure to take a buddy with you. Many beaches will have lifeguards on duty, and these guys and girls will show you which areas are safe for swimming. Our beaches are also really great for an early morning jog or run, and that brings me to my bonus tip, and that is live location. So now that you have a South African SIM card in your phone, it will make your data costs much cheaper, which means that if you are worried about going for a run in the morning, all you need to do is share your live location with your tour guide or friends and have peace of mind that somebody knows exactly where you are. So it's almost time to say goodbye, and I just want to say thank you for watching. I really hope I managed to address any of the questions you might have had about your safety while traveling in South Africa. If you found my video to be useful or at least a little bit entertaining, feel free to like, subscribe, and share this with everyone who you feel might benefit from it. And of course, if you have any questions about South Africa or requests for future videos, chat to me in the comments section below or find me, Nick VT, on social media. I'm a real bad boy on the town on the